So in this video lecture, we are going to focus on membrane-bound mediated responses, and specifically what we will be focusing on within those membrane-mediated responses are what are called ligand-gated channels. So this is just to give you an introduction to these ligand-gated channels, and then we'll have some specific information for you in future videos. So these are the types of channels. Now, you've already been introduced to leak channels, and remember that leak channels are always open. Remember that leak channels also exhibit specificity. So we've already seen examples of sodium leak channels and potassium leak channels. Now there are also a type of channel called gated channels, and there are four different types of gated channels. Here we'll only focus on chemically or ligand-gated channels. Later in the semester, we'll talk about voltage-gated, mechanically gated, and thermally gated. So what this means if you're looking at a ligand-gated channel is here we have all of these ligands. Here's sodium, here's acetylcholine, a ligand that you'll become quite familiar with later on in the semester. And here is your channel in blue. And so notice how the shape of the ligand binds. It's the same shape as the site on your receptor, and that binds to the channel, and then the channel will respond to that. So now let's go ahead and look at the two different types of ligand-gated channels. So we have what are called fast ligand-gated channels, and we have slow ligand-gated channels. So we're going to talk about both. So a fast ligand-gated channel, the receptor is the same protein as the channel, and a slow ligand-gated channel, the receptor is a different protein than the channel. Now, fast channels are called that because they cause a response within milliseconds, whereas a slow ligand-gated channel will take minutes. So let's start with a fast ligand-gated channel. So with a fast ligand-gated channel, remember it's fast, so the receptor and the ion channel are the exact same protein. So how does this work? We're going to start with your messenger, which is called a ligand. Your ligand binds to the receptor. You could also say the ligand binds to the channel since they're the same protein. So then once that happens, the channel opens and it does not close. It will only open when a ligand binds to it. That's really important. So when the channel opens, then you have ions that can move into or out of the cell. Now, some of these channels will exhibit specificity. So perhaps you'll only have chloride moving through this channel, or you'll only have sodium or maybe potassium. Or in some cases, you can have both sodium and potassium moving through the same channel. So in this example, let's just assume that you have sodium moving into the cell. So we have what's called sodium influx. So sodium carries a positive charge. And since sodium is moving into the cell becomes, or the intracellular fluid, becomes more positive. So what we've done then is we've changed the electrical properties of the cell. Now here's an example of a fast ligand-gated channel called a calcium channel. And so in this particular situation, since it's called a calcium channel, we know that calcium is going to be the ion moving through the channel. So here's our ligand. It's bound to our channel, which again is also the receptor. And when the channel opens, calcium enters the cell through the channel. And then that causes a number of target cell responses. Since there are positive charges coming into the cell, that changes the electrical property, right? The intracellular fluid is more positive. The calcium that's moving into the intracellular fluid can be used for muscle contraction. It can cause secretion. You can also use calcium as a second messenger, which we'll talk about later. Calcium then can combine to something called calmodulin, which can activate an enzyme called protein kinase. And we might as well go ahead and remind you that protein kinase functions via covalent regulation. It's an enzyme and covalently regulates. And so what protein kinase always does is it always phosphorylates a protein. And then you get some sort of response inside of the cell. So again, this is just to give you an idea of what a fast ligand-gated channel is and how it can change the properties within the cell. So you can change electrical properties, you can have contraction occur. It just depends on what specific tissue that you're in. And we haven't gotten to what tissue we're in yet. Right now, it's just understanding what a membrane-bound mediated response is, in the fact that you can have these fast ligand-gated channels. The channel will always open, the channel and the receptor are the same protein, and you get some sort of response in the cell.